Recording! Carol, it's all you.
So I'm presenting Largo, which are the wide plays of the sword, which tend to arise when the two opponents are a little bit further away from each other when they get into their crossing. So the first play is a little bit deceptive because there's two different actions that play out from the first play, but it's still all just one play. So in the first play, if Alex were to throw me an attack, and he were to just come throw a true attack that does not cross the center line, I can respond very simply by obliquing him away and hitting him in the head in the same go. And the follow-on to that is same action, and I come in with a second step and thrust him. Now, if he were alternately to cross the center line with his attack, I would do a different action altogether. I would start off with the same thing in mind, but upon feeling that he is crossing, I come around to the other side. Now, all of that is the decision you make when the crossing occurs at the tips of the sword. Now, when the crossing happens at the middle, I do something differently altogether, which is to come down on his hands and then thrust him. Another thing I could do if we're crossed at the middle and he slides down to my hilt is I can grab him. And the follow-up to that is one of two things happen. Either I hit him, or if we're even closer together, I can kick him either on the shin or under the knee while I hit him. So the next play is if he were to try to attack below my knees. Fiore specifically says that trying to attack somebody below the knees is a bad idea, mostly because it is too far for them to reach, as you will see. So I can either withdraw or I can take a passing step back and just hit him in the head. And even though he is much taller than me and much longer than me, I still hit him easily and he is not hitting me. Fiore does specify that the only time it is okay to hit somebody below the knee is if you are lying on the ground. So if you're already on the ground, it's okay.
You better do it now.
Yeah. So the next play is the groin kick. So
good, let's see that.
So if Alex were to come in and attack me, and if we wind up close, hold on, let's do that again and start off. So we start off farther away, but come close, I can then come in with the groin kick. And it specifically says in the book that I come in with the groin claw, the groin kick, which makes him miss his parry. So the use of it is to help him not deflect, like not catch my attack, and then I can attack him even more with the sword. Alternately, if Alex were the one coming in with the groin kick, he does suggest a counter, which is to catch him, and Fiore specifies you have to do it very quickly. So you catch his foot and shove it aside.
I just take him to the ground.
The next plays are when we get into responses to thrusts. So the first one is the exchange point, which is as Alex thrusts in, I catch it with my cross, and in the same action, point my sword at his face, and my follow-through would be to stab him. Now, Fiore also suggests an alternative for if your beginning exchange of points, either you hesitate or if your point is not actually pointed at your opponent. So if Alex thrusts me again, and I'm all the way over here, what I can do is I can reach in, grab his hilt, and now I have all sorts of things I can do. Another response to thrusts is the breaking point. So the breaking point is if Alex comes in with a thrust again, I can respond by beating his sword to the ground. What I do after I have the sword on the ground is I will step on it. Now, if I were doing this for real, I would do it with force, with the intention of ideally breaking the sword, or at least just getting it firmly into the ground. And Fiore then says that what you can do is you come up under his beard and then down on his hands.
Well, she's cut it off.
Oh, yes.
Yes. Yes, his beard is gone. Look, I did it.
Duh.
So another thing that Fiore specifies with breaking a point is if Alex comes in again, gets the sword to the ground, and then Fiori says that in one play you can hit him and step on the sword in the same timing. And he specifies that it's a fendente to the head. So it's coming from above, which I interpret to mean just that there are lots of different ways that you can hit him. Then we have I'm missing one. Then, okay, we're going to move on. Then we have the, I know which one. So alternately, if Alex comes in with a thrust, and I break the thrust, and if I were to come up to attack him and he parries, then my response would be to go with it, catch him and hit him around the neck in a half sword type position. Now this works especially in the same way as the first play, which I demonstrated, in that instead of trying to counter and go against him moving my sword, I'm just going with it and making him coming in on the other side. So now the next play is the elbow push. So with this play comes immediately after the thrusting section, but Fiori does not specify that it is in response to either exchange a point or breaking a point. How I interpreted it is if Alex were to come in and if I were to oppose him from a guard on this side, I'm all of a sudden making room and I've already got his sword sort of coming over in that direction, and I now have the space where I can give him an elbow push and twist him to the side. And the follow-on action to that, once I have twisted his body away from me, is to then hit him. And the final one is the feint, which is a provocation play. So in this play, I am going to make a very big, difficult-looking swing, hard-looking swing, towards Alex. And as soon as we make the contact, I'm going to come back into half-sword and this way. Let's do it one more time. I got this. So, looks super fancy, but I'm coming in, and I'm going to hit Alex and thrust him to all the gooey bits. So, he also shows a counter to that. So, if Alex were to try to do that to me, I counter by doing the same thing, but I'm over top of his sword, so he cannot attack, hit me, but I can hit him.
Okay, yeah. That's it.
Thank you.